Hello everyone, hi, welcome to the channel of Wall Street Mojo.
Watch the video till the end, and also if you are new to this channel, then you can subscribe us by clicking the bell icon.
Friends, today we are going to learn a new concept, that is operating profit margin formula. This is the part and parcel of ratio analysis. Let's understand the formula. As you can see, the operating profit margin formula is equal to your operating profit, that is your earning before interest and tax, EBIT, divide by your net sales into 100. So we'll understand each component. What is exactly the net sales? What is the operating profit? Okay, let's get started. The operating profit margin is basically the profitability ratio that is avidly used by the investors. This is such a popular operating margin ratio because the investors can get to know how much a firm earns in terms of operating profit. Okay. Now, the formula of operating profit margin is as follow, is equal to your operating profit divided by net sales, the whole into 100. So let's take an example so that we understand the operating profit margin in a good fashion. Let's take a simple example to illustrate the formula. Let's say there is a company called ABC and it has been provided with the following data. Gross sales is the first item, 5,64,000, let's say. Then there is a thing called sales return, which is 54,000. Then there is a cost of goods sold, COGS, which is 2,40,000. And there is labor expense. There's labor expense, which is 43,000. And finally, the general and admin expense is 57,000. So based on this, find out the operating profit margin for ABC company. In this example, the first thing we need to find is the net sales, which is 54,000. Okay. Sorry. The gross sale, I'm just writing over here. The gross sale, sales return, and the net sales will come. So our net sales is going to be your gross sales, right? Minus your sales return is going to be your net sales. Now, to find out the gross profit, we need to deduct the cost of the goods sold from the net sales. So the gross profit, would be something like this. Gross profit would be is equal to your net sales less the COGS, right? This whole thing is going to be your gross profit, which is your 2,70,000. So now we will deduct the operating expenses from the gross profit to find out the operating profit. So the operating profit, which is the next thing in our list, the operating profit will be your gross profit, that is your 2,70,000, less any labor expenses, 43,000, less GNA, that is general and administrative expenses, which will finally lend us to operating profit. So using this operating margin formula, we get operating profit margin formula is equal to 1,70,000, that is your operating profit, divide by the net sales and just make it percentage, which is 33.33. Now we'll talk about a real life example of operating profit margin. Okay, and we are going to take an example of Colgate. Now this is the operating profit margin of Colgate. This is a snapshot of Colgate's income statement from 2007 to 2015. The net sales, the cost of sales, and the gross profit data is given. Based on this, after deducting the selling and general administrative expenses, other expenses, and charges of other accounting change, you get your final EBIT, right? The earning before interest and tax. So based on this, we have this data right in front of us. So Colgate's operating profit is going to be your EBIT divided by your gross profit. So historically, Colgate's operating profit has remained in the range of 20 to 23%, close enough to that. Let's try and find out what's exactly that goes in graph. See, however, in 2015, Colgate's EBIT margin has decreased significantly to 17.4, as you can see over here. And this was the primarily due to the change in the accounting terms of CP. Okay. Now let's get into the explanation part of the operating profit margin formula. Now in the operating profit margin formula, we have the very two component. The first component is the operating profit, right? This is the first component. So we get to the operating profit by deducting any CO, the cost of goods sold, the COGS, and any other expenses from the net sales. And if you look at the income statement of the company, you would be able to discover the operating earnings quite well. So this is the speciality of the operating income, is that it does not include income or expenses except the income or expenses relating to the operating profit. So no non-operating data will be inputted in this particular arena. The second component in the above operating margin formula is the net sales. That is the second most important thing. Now we start with the income statement with the gross sales. And the gross sales are the total revenue earned by the company. But to find out the net sales, we need to deduct any sales return from the same or the discount from the gross sales. And in the operating margin ratio above, we compare the operating profit and the net sales to find out the proportion. Now, what is exactly the use of the operating profit margin formula? Well, there are many firms which emphasize the net profit margin. The net profit is the result of the whole income and expenses rendered by the company. But if the net profit margin is higher, then it is better thing for the company. And it does not ensure that the efficiency of the company. It may hide the actual profit generated by the operating profit effort of the company. So that's why the investor should look at the operating profit, since operating profit helps to find out the actually how much profit the company have made from its operations. It's a very important word. It ensures the efficiency and profitability, and that's the reason it is one of the most significant profitability ratio of all. See, while finding out the profit margin, the investor should look at the gross profit margin and the net profit margin. But along with that, they should look for the operating margin, which will surely bridge the gap in the understanding how a company is actually doing operationally. Now, based on this, we can finally understand with the help of a calculator, which we have been provided, and we can change some numbers in there. So over here, the operating profit is let's say, if it is 2,50,000 and your net sales is, let's say, 1,000,000. 2,50,000, and this is your 1,000,000. So that is going to be a 25% as in operating margin formula. Now, the moment you reduce this to, let's say, 2,00,000, then your margin will reduce. And the moment you increase this, your margin will automatically increase. So what is the relation that we get? The higher the operating profit, okay, higher will be the margin, and the vice versa the case. In both the scenario, this is going to be the relation between the same. And it's good. The ratio will be considered appropriate and good and efficient if higher profit ratio or higher operating margin has been reported.
So that's it for this particular topic. If you have learned and enjoyed watching this video, please like and comment on this video and subscribe to our channel for the latest updates. Thank you, everyone. Cheers.